So it's Black Friday. It was Thanksgiving yesterday. Happy Thanksgiving, everyone. Thanksgiving's a really dumb holiday. Like, I feel like it's the type of holiday nobody really knows now why we do it, because nobody was really into the original reason, which is not very nice. And so it's like, oh, well, actually, we're celebrating something that's really messed up, so let's just do Thanksgiving anyway, but we don't really know why we're celebrating it, so we should just all spend the day being thankful for things. I mean, don't get me wrong, being thankful for things is good practice, but you should do that every day. It shouldn't just be one day a year, and you can't just sort of take the meaning, the original meaning of a day, and then turn it into actually be something else because you realise that the original meaning is really nasty. Anyway, I'm not going to talk about that. I was going to talk about another aspect of weird, stupid food rules that cultures grasp onto. Because I talked about mindful eating and the problem with mindful eating and actually how you should eat mindlessly when you are eating disorder recovery in my last video. And then somebody brought up this idea that I have heard of quite a lot, where apparently it takes 20 minutes before your body understands that it's full. So, that being said, the idea is what you should do is you should eat something, and then you should wait 20 minutes. So you eat something and you still feel hungry, and then you wait 20 minutes with the idea that it takes 20 minutes for the message from your gut to get to your brain that says, I'm actually not hungry anymore. And if you say it like that, it sounds really stupid, gotta admit. Because if you think about it, like, signals are pretty instant between, you know, like, so if I think, blink my eye, it just, that, if, imagine if it took 20 minutes for me to give the cue, blink my eye, and then my eye would blink. It would be really messed up. It would be like, all right, I'm going to blink. And then you'd wait 20 minutes, and then you'd forgotten about it, and then you'd blink, and then people would be like, what the hell are you doing? So, also, so even if it wasn't sort of this electrical instant magic signal that our bodies do, say if it was more like a signal where you write it down, you take it to a piece of paper and you give it to somebody and they read it and then it happens. So you're talking like snail mail. Even the distance from my stomach to my brain isn't very far. So even if somebody was walking that, even if it was a very small ant walking it, an ant could walk that distance in 20 minutes. So, logically, it doesn't make any sense that it would take 20 minutes for your stomach to be able to communicate with your brain. I just want to take a break for a minute and talk about Teddy, because as you guys know, I lost my beloved cat, Stinky, almost 3 weeks ago. That'll be 3 weeks tomorrow. And I'm still really sad about that. But Teddy has stepped up his game. He's just basically following me around the whole time. I had to do barn chores yesterday because I gave my barn staff the day off because it's Thanksgiving, duh. And Teddy was there all day with me, mucking stools, filling hay nets, doing water. He just follows me around all day since Stinky went. And then, he's a feral cat. Weird. Anyway. So, I'm thankful for Teddy. All right, what was I talking about? Okay, so this idea it takes 20 minutes for you to eat something and for your stomach to register that it's been eaten and to get that to your brain. And then we've explained how that just doesn't make any sense on any level. And there's no other system in the body where it takes 20 minutes to get a signal across. It doesn't take 20 minutes. So say, for example, if you need to go for a pee, by that logic, you would go for a pee and then it would take 20 minutes for you to feel like you didn't need to go for a pee anymore. It happens instantly, doesn't it? You need to go for a pee and then you go to the toilet and you go for a pee and the feeling of needing to go for a pee is no longer there. That should take 20 minutes. So with this logic, if you're supposed to sit and not eat for 20 minutes, what you should do is you should go for a pee and then you should sit on the toilet for 20 minutes, because it takes 20 minutes apparently for signals to get from other parts of our bodies to our brains. So shouldn't that go for everything? I just feel like because we live in a culture that is terrified of weight gain, people just make up stupid shit, just make up stuff. And then other people just think that sounds clever. So they go, oh, that sounds clever. That sounds clever that it takes 20 minutes for your brain to know that you're actually full. Let's all do that. Because everybody is afraid of weight gain. So any idea that somebody can present that says, here's a reason, here's an idea how you can restrict food. Everybody else goes, oh, obviously that's true. That must be true. I've got to try it. Like, take all the stupid diets out there, intermittent fasting, all these different types of intermittent fasting. So one type says you should fast for like 72 hours and then eat for 24 hours. And another type says that you should fast for 10 hours and then eat for 2. All these stupid shit that people just make up, which is just dancing around the same topic of how can we work out how to not eat as much because we're all afraid of getting bigger than a size 10 UK. And so... you've got to take that into account when you are listening to this shit. You've got to take it into account. People are afraid of weight gain. Everybody wants to be underweight. That's our culture. It glamorizes that. That doesn't mean it's right. And just because we live in a culture that says everybody, regardless of their height, age, body type, all these other things, needs to be a size zero, US, then people just make up stuff that supports it, and other people just go along with it. And it's not actually that everybody's stupid, although sometimes I do actually think that that might be the case, but it's probably not actually that everybody is really stupid. It's just that people are fearful of weight gain. And because when people are fearful, we do act really stupid. It's just one of the mechanisms of fear. Do you know why that is? It's because fear kind of shuts off the thinking part of your brain. And so when you're afraid, slightly afraid of weight gain, someone presents some absurd idea, let's just eat kale for the rest of our lives, and people go, great, yeah, I'll do it. Rather than actually thinking about it and thinking, you know what, I wonder why my body gives me desires to eat foods other than kale. I mean, is it just that my body is an asshole like that? Is my body just a complete pain in the ass? And really, you know, what's good for my body is kale, but my body wants to eat other things just because, for the hell of it, just because my body wants to mess itself up, and just because my body wants to mess me up, and my body's just a pain. Like, really, that's how people think. You know why your body wants to eat things other than kale? It's because kale will not sustain it. It really is as simple as that. Your body has the only agenda it has is to optimize health so it can try and live as long as possible, the same as every other organism out there. That's what they're all trying to do so they can pass on genes. And so if your body says, hey, you know, you need to go and eat a burger, it's not doing that just to be an asshole. It's doing that because it knows it needs something of substance, and it needs some fat, and it needs some other things. It's not just because your body's trying to have a giggle and be like, I'm going to go and make the human eat a burger and really freak everything out. And you know what? Maybe I'll die of something because I ate a burger. Like, your body's not going to do that. Your body's trying to live. So get it out of your head that your body is trying to self-destruct, because it isn't. It's actually trying to help you out and get you to live longer. So stop listening to all these idiots that bring up these stupid rules, which are just basically other ways to restrict. And start listening to the only non-idiot in the room, which is your body. All right, happy Black Friday. Go do some shopping or something. Bye.